We are under the lights this evening as we get you set for another edition of Baseball on the Show. Ought to be a good one here between the New York Yankees and the Oakland A's. Major League Baseball on the Show is next. Series opener. And please, Zach, what's the word on him?
Hey, it just goes to show you how tough it is to pitch in today's game. This guy has a career ERA over 5. At times he can be good, and at times he can be really, really bad. It'll be interesting to see which guy shows up in this one here today.
And that sends DJ LeMahieu into the box. And we are set for baseball. Here this evening. Here's the first pitch to him. Now a ball lined to the left side, but this will be a foul ball.
First pitch, 7-0-7.
The windup and the 0-1. Bat explodes as this has popped up. And that's the first out. With that, here's a look at the Yankees' starting lineup. Who's the one to watch, Dan?
Yeah, I'm keeping an eye on DJ LeMahieu. He had over 100 RBIs last year. That's the goal of every big hitter. If I can drive in 100, that means I had a good year, and I would say he had a pretty good year.
And that'll bring up Aaron Judge as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. And Dan Dero, this Oakland ball club entering play here tonight. They come in off a good victory last time out, but one that was just their second win in their last 8 tries.
Yeah, Matty, this is a classic case of hitting is contagious. They scored a bunch of runs last game, and this team is flying high right now. This is a fight at the bat rack.
And it's a ball and 2 strikes now to Aaron Judge. 53 degrees here at game time as it's cooled off considerably since batting practice this afternoon. The 1-2. Bases are empty, one man out. Swing and a miss as he ran that two-seamer right by him for the second out.
This is why it's so hard to be successful as a hitter when you fall behind in the count. 1-2, you're probably expecting some sort of off-speed pitches, but when the pitcher offers up a good hard fastball, it's pretty hard to adjust and catch up to it.
And that'll bring up Gleyber Torres. As he'll take a look at a strike right down the middle, it's 0-1. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2.
I get it. He wants to see this guy's repertoire, but now he's behind in the count. Puts himself in a tough spot to hit.
Fly ball right down the line and left. Davis on the move. Into the corner, he makes the catch to end the inning. So the Yanks go 1-2-3. Yankees nothing. A's coming to bat. You're watching Major League Baseball on the Show. Masahiro Tanaka, the right-hander from Japan, will get the starting assignment in this one. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, every team needs a pitcher like this one here. His numbers aren't going to blow you away. Career ERA just under 4. But one thing he does, he takes the ball every 5 days, throws strikes, and gives his team a chance to win every single time he goes out there. It'll be fun to watch in this one here today.
And that'll bring in Ramon Laureano. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Watches a fastball right there for strike one. And as the Yankees get started here tonight, guys, well, they've been on a pretty good roll of late, winners of 7 of their last 8 ball games.
What an opportunity to get a chance to put our eyeballs on one of the best teams in baseball right now. This team has played so well. Their manager has been on point. Every move he makes is working. Timely hitting, great defense, good bullpen. The starters have been on point. This is going to be special.
Time now for a glance at Bob Melvin's A's starting lineup. Nero, give us what you have on this lineup as they start a new series.
Matty, this lineup is built on one thing. Their best tool is the fact that they have amazing speed up and down the lineup. I don't even think the third base coach gives a steal sign. I think a lot of these guys have the green light. So be on the lookout for that today.
At the plate, Tony Kemp. Yes, he'll take a called strike here on a borderline pitch at strike one. Curveball there. This one touching 77 miles an hour. Two strikes.
Yeah, this is straight survival mode. Down 0-2. The numbers are definitely not with the batter here.
And he looks at a ball. 1-2.
Hey, that 0-2 fastball wasn't even close, but I'm hit right now. I'm still sitting on that heater.
Fouled off. One out, nobody on. And a splitter swung on and missed that time, and that'll be out number two.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
Standing in now, Marcus Semien. As he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. He's ready for his first at-bat of this early season contest. Tanaka into his motion. Here's the 0-1. Popped him up. Andujar in foul ground. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. Nothing in the Oakland first. On to the second now from the Coliseum. Still scoreless. And digging into the batter's box next will be Giancarlo Stanton. Hitless in four tries in the ballgame yesterday. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. The 1-0. Now a ball hit pretty well to left, but this is going to wind up in the seats foul. The 1-1 home. Is laid off for ball two. And set up working the plate is Matthew Ross, as you see the rest of the umpiring crew there.
Well, D-Row, you better be ready to swing. With Matt Ross behind the dish, big zone.
Yeah, you know coming into this one, you better pull the trigger. If something's close, Matt Ross is going to punch your ticket.
Into the corner and slicing foul. Three balls and two strikes to the Yankees DH. And that misses for ball four. So it's a leadoff walk here to start the second.
And I'm sure the manager is just fine with that. I mean, it's better to battle a slugger like that to the end and end up walking him than serving one up where he can really hurt you.
So coming to the plate, Aaron Hicks. He comes into this April contest as one of the hottest hitters in the league. His season average up into the high 300s now.
Wow, this guy's off to a blazing start, catching a lot of people by surprise. It's still early. We'll have to see if he can keep this up through the rest of the year.
Laid off the bender there, but it's in for a called strike. Stanton on at first, nobody out. In the dirt here. Good job there as the count goes to 1-2. Curveball got him swinging for the first out.
That was some nice execution on that pitch. Spotted it nicely down around the bottom of the zone. And when you do that, especially with two strikes, not a lot of guys are going to hurt you. You're going to get a lot of ground balls and swings and misses down there.
Here's Miguel Andujar now. Now a little pop-up here right in front of the plate. Olson has a play, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning.
Batting seven.
So striding forward now, Gary Sanchez. Day off for him yesterday, but back out there for this one. Here's the first pitch to him.
Ball one. You got to love that as a hitter right there. It doesn't happen much, but when it does, you have to find a way to take advantage of the count.
The 1-0 home.
Well, that'll wake everyone up. Anytime you buzz the tower like that, there's reason for people to start getting a little bit edgy.
Hit hard down the left field line, but this will be foul. Popped him up. Chapman is there. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. The Yanks leave one. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. That'll bring up the power hitter, Matt Olson. And he's definitely off to a fast start in the early part of the season. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. Good deception on the slider there as he's way out in front. And that misses 1-1. Looked like he tried to pull it there, but he swings right through the fastball. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one.
He was looking for a swing and a missed breaker right there, but left that one in the zone that got fouled off.
Fouled away. The 1-2.
The classic back foot slider right there with two strikes. Usually gets a ton of swing and misses. Nice layoff right there. Fight for another pitch.
Pulled high in the air out to right field. Judge is on his horse. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning.
All right, here's how the Bronx Bombers are going to set up defensively today. And the guy I want to focus on is second baseman DJ LeMahieu. I think what we need to take into consideration is his ability to play that position at 6'4", 6'5", with soft hands and the ability to turn a double play. We already know he's an offensive force.
So now it's Mark Canna. As Tanaka jumps ahead of him here at strike one. Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2.
Every time you go out there to start a game on the mound, you hope to settle in quickly and get into a groove, and he's definitely done that so far in the early going. Looks like he could go pretty deep into this one.
One ball and two strikes to count. Pitch on the way. And a splitter swung on and missed that time, and that'll be out number two. Now at the plate, Matt Chapman. As he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Who the jiggy with the goal links? Tanaka sets his sights. Here's the delivery. Now a fastball on the inside corner, and he takes a look at strike one. Just a bit late, and he's fallen behind 0-2. Still looking for our first hit in the ballgame. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Some of our nation's young minds and future leaders here in attendance. Yikes. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show after this. All set for the start of the inning, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Gio Urshela.
Gio Urshela.
First pitch on its way. Fly ball out toward left center field. Center fielder on the run. He gets there and makes the play for the first out. So here's the veteran Brett Gardner. He's ready for his first at bat of this early season contest. Now here it comes.
Yeah, that looked like a strike, but let me tell you, when you're staring at a big zero in the hit column, getting a call like that to go your way can feel like a big victory.
Turned on, but it's wide of first and foul.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1. Both teams so far yet to crack the hit column. And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right. Popped up. And he'll lunge out of the crouch to make the play for out number two.
That's exactly what they wanted out of that pitch up in the zone. They took him up the ladder, and he couldn't get up to it. So that was an easy pop out. Well executed pitch there.
Back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring in DJ LeMahieu. Here's the first pitch to him. Now a swing and a miss. Took something off that one, and it's strike one. Off speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. Third inning, no score to this point. Two balls and a strike now to the Yankees leadoff man.
Everything this guy throws moves. That two-seamer has a mind of its own.
3-1. Aaron Judge would be next. Hit on the ground for Simeon at short. He's got it. And a close play at first, but he's called out and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. Home half of the third coming up. No score. Here's Chris Davis now. 7, 8, and 9 to start the home third.
Not much going on offensively so far for these guys. Six up, six down. Let's see if the bottom part of the lineup can get something going.
Well, the home crowd seems a little restless, so I'm sure they'd appreciate it. The 0-1 delivery. And he fouls this one off. Davis, a 32-year-old veteran. This is the final year of his current deal, so he'll be a free agent at season's end.
You know, Matty, I know he's in the final year of his contract, but he's playing to expectations, to be honest with you. I know he wants to turn it up a little bit, though, as he approaches the end of the season and make that salary push as he heads towards free agency again.
Outfielder Stephen Piscotty the next to hit. He was 1-for-4 back in Wednesday's contest. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Line drive to left. But this will hang up just enough as he takes it in stride in left center for the second out. Digging in, Austin Allen. Tanaka's ready. Here comes the first pitch. And a check swing here, but he clearly went around on a pitch that would have been a strike anyway. It's nothing and one. Breaking ball below the zone. That's ball one. Pulls this one into the air out into right field. Judge is under it. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the A's. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. All set for the start of the fourth. And next it'll be the outfielder, Aaron Judge.
This game is rolling right along as we move into the middle innings with no score. You'd think by now one of these two teams would be able to get some base runners on and get them in, but that hasn't been the case.
And the first pitch of the inning here misses down and in for a ball. That's 1-0. Still all zeros in the run column here in the fourth inning. Dan, does this continue or does somebody score here?
I think this continues for a while, Matt. Both of these pitchers are throwing very well, throwing strikes, having good command of their off-speed pitches. This is going to be one of those low-scoring affairs.
This is a spot you really don't want to be in with a great hitter like that. You can't just lay one in there, but you also don't want to run the count to 3-0.
3-0 to him now. And, oh, they won't let him walk that easily, as that somehow ruled a strike. 3-1 now. And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four.
They haven't been able to register a hit against this guy, but at least they have a base runner here. We'll see if that leads to something.
Now at the plate, Torres, 0-1 for him here in this one. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Good slider there. Gets a swing and miss.
Hey, this is a perfect opportunity for them to get on the board right now. Leadoff man has done his job, and now the middle of the order gets their shot at the plate.
0-1 pitch on its way. And he'll look at a fastball just off the black, and it's even at one. Yankees still on the lookout for hit number one here. Swung on, but it's pulled foul wide of third. And it's fouled away. Ball two. Softly hit down to third, likely no shot at two. And indeed, no look at second. He'll go straight to first and take the sure out.
Now batter.
Giancarlo Stanton now. He drew a base on balls his first time up. From the stretch. First pitch is a slider called for a strike. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. Too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside. Out in front there as this one's pulled off to the left side. The 1-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Pulled him just enough with that pitch to get him to go around, according to the umpire. Sometimes it can be really tough for these big, strong guys because once they're committed to swinging, it's hard for them to slow their swings down, and that appeared to be the case there.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. No runs, no hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far. Tried to get him to go after the slider, but it's 1-1. One and one, the pitch. Line to the right side. That's a hit, the first of the game for the Yankees. And the runner at third will put the brakes on here as they didn't want to chance it even with two outs.
Hey, sometimes you need a little bit of luck, too, as a pitcher. This ball absolutely scorched. Actually hit so hard that it wasn't able to drive a run in.
Yeah, I'm actually surprised. I know that ball was hit on a line. Surprised that third base coach held him with two outs.
And that'll bring up Miguel Andujar. He'll swing and lift a ball fouled off to the left and out of play. He popped out in his first trip.
Hey,
comes set. The 0-1. Now a ball lined to the left side. Foul.
He got the fastball where he wanted and just pulled off of it.
Line hard, but foul. Runners at the corners, two men out. A ball and two strikes now.
It's a great job to lay off on that nasty slider right there. It's the toughest pitch. It was my toughest pitch to lay off of. I was always sitting fastball middle away, and when that slider came out, boy.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Yanks strand a pair. On to the bottom of the fourth now, still with no score. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Ramon Laureano. Back to the top of the lineup as they're still looking for their first base runner in this one.
No doubt about that, Matt. They've yet to figure this guy out on the mound. He's looked great so far.
He has, but we'll see if this second trip through the order changes anything.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments these hitters are able to make in the middle innings of this game.
And he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
You could definitely tell this hitter's been guessing at the plate and guessing wrong. But here's where you can't expand the zone. You have to take a deep breath and try and fight yourself back to an even count.
And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first down.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line, but that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best two-strike approach either.
At the plate now, Tony Kemp. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. He's 0 for 1 thus far. It's 1-1 to Tony Kemp. And here's a pitch swung on and missed. 1-2 now. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. Heading after it is Judge. Lays out, and he's got it. A great play for route number two.
There are two parts to every great catch. One, getting the right route to make the play. And two, hanging on. That was a terrific diving catch by the outfielder.
So bases are empty here with two gone. And up next, a Berkeley area native, Marcus Semien. First pitch of the at-bat. Good deception on the slider there as he's way out in front. Behind 0-2 now. Nothing in two count and the pitch.
Hey, the fish ain't biting there on that 0-2 breaking ball, but you got to be careful because this pitcher might throw him another one.
1-2, here it comes. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. A's are gone in order. Through four, still tied, nothing. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with the Yankees manager Aaron Boone during the break about the team's offensive performance so far, and flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. He said there is nothing prettier than frozen rope after frozen rope, and that is exactly what he's getting right now. The data says they've hit 8 line drives as a team in this one, some resulting in outs, but obviously that's a good sign for them going forward.
Thank you, Heidi. Striding in once again, Gary Sanchez. He'll start things out here in a tie ball game. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Swing and a liner. But this will be taken in out there at short, and that's the first out of the inning.
Now batting.
That'll bring in Giovanni Urshela. Fly down in his first at bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far. pitch on the way. And that swung on and missed for strike one.
Although he doesn't use that pitch too much, if he's able to steal some strikes early in the count, could be something they have to think about.
Slider, and he can't pull the trigger. Two strikes. Urshela takes the swings from the right-handed batter's box, but he's one of those rare hitters that actually thrives facing same-handed pitching. One of the very best in the game, as a matter of fact, in that type of matchup.
Yeah, Matty, he does not leap.
Throw in the dirt to first, and he can't come up with it cleanly.
The left fielder, number 11.
Well, you can't fault the effort by the first baseman there. He did his best to make the save, stretching to his backhand side. He just can't quite close the glove on it, so it'll go down as a throwing error.
Stepping in, Brett Gardner, 0 for 1 after a pop-out in foul territory his first time through.
Yeah, we used to have a saying right here, you would stride to the plate for this AB trying to chop wood. Not in today's game. You just want to get your bat plane on the same path of the ball. Can't continue to swing under those elevated heaters.
That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
I know it's cliche and it's tired at times, but a well-located fastball down at the knees is still the best pitch in the game.
On its way, the 0-2 pitch. No runs, just one hit, and no errors for the Yankees so far. Curveball bounces, and this one gets away. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. And forget about the double play now as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch.
Well, when you throw a breaking ball in the dirt, that's the danger. You have to trust your catcher, but this one skips away and the open base takes the double opportunity away with it. Might prove to be costly.
A shot down the first baseline and a reach, but it's by him as he couldn't quite get to that ball. He pulls into second safely as they jump ahead with a run scoring on the play. So much of this game is situational hitting, guys. Nice job there.
Yeah, you've got to find a way to pick your teammates up when you're given the chance. And he doesn't try to do too much right here. He just takes what's there. Safely on second, and his buddy is high-fiving teammates in the dugout.
Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. He swings and sends it in the air out to left center. He can't track it down as this ball falls. And the run will score from second to make this a 2-0 ball game.
Now batting, right fielder, Aaron Judge.
Here's big Aaron Judge as he'll look at a fastball in there on the outer half. It's 0-1. It was a walk in his last trip. Hit down the third baseline, but that'll get foul. It's 0-2 now. Runner at first here, one man out. Can't quite get the low outside corner there. It's 1-2. Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first and no swing. It's ball two. Full count now. 3-2.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
From the belt, kicks and deals. Weak grounder down the line at third, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again, 3-2. Lifted down the line in left. And that's going to land foul. The 3-2 one more time.
Four foul balls in this AB. Pitcher cannot find anywhere to go to put this guy away.
He'll try it again, 3-2. Down the third baseline. Foul. Hit back up the middle. Simeon's got it to second for one. Relay to Olsen. They turn the double play, and that retires the side. So two runs on two hits, one Oakland error, and no one left. Home half of the fifth coming up. It's the Yankees 2 and the A's nothing. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Well, Matt, I talked to manager Bob Melvin during the break about his thoughts on the A's hitters to this point. And he was pretty blunt in saying they're just not having very good at-bats. They haven't had a single guy on base yet, so it's starting to feel a little desperate down here. But he said they've unfortunately just been faced with some really great pitching today. The key going forward is to find any way they can to get him out of his rhythm on the mound. Now, that may be a tall task, but they feel the little adjustments could lead to things turning around for them.
All right, thanks, Heidi. First pitch on its way. Matt Olson is at the plate as he takes a cold strike one.
Hey, he's rolling so far in this one as we head into the middle part of this game. How about 90% of his first pitches have been for strikes? If he continues to do that, he just might finish this one.
And this is taken in for out number one. Coming in, Mark Canna is a strikeout victim in his first try. The pitch. And he catches the inside corner for a called strike. Nothing in one.
Pitcher wants to have a quick inning right here. Capitalize on the momentum his batters have.
Behind 0-2 now. A's still looking for that elusive first hit of the ballgame. Line drive to left. And there's the first hit of the game for the A's.
Boy, that's not a bad pitch right there. That's a pretty good sinker. He just happens to hook that one right into left field for a base hit.
Yeah, he got the bat head out right there, Dan, and was able to get that one to left field.
Yeah.
So that brings up the always intense Matt Chapman.
Yeah.
Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Yeah.
Who did Ziggy put the goal in? Got me reminiscing about my old age.
Here comes the first pitch. Ready with the 1-0. Maybe a little jumpy there as he swings through the fastball.
Hey, now he's got me confused up here. This is a known sinker baller out on the mound trying to roll a double play, and he throws him a four-seamer.
Hit out towards second. Step on the bag for one. Relay to first in time, and just like that, this side is retired. So put another zero on the board as they've been held scoreless through five. Five innings complete. It's the Yankees 2 and the A's nothing. New inning set to get underway, and stepping up is the shortstop, Torres.
The shortstop, Labor Torres.
First pitch of the at-bat. Now a slider, and he gets ahead of him here 0-1. Couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Now a ball hit pretty well to left, but this is going to wind up in the seats foul. And the pitch. Nope. Breaking ball below the zone. That's ball one.
Hey, that's a nice take by the batter right there, but that's a non-competitive off-speed pitch. Got to do better to at least entice a swing.
And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2.
Hey, expect a challenge right here. Does not want to run the count full.
And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
What a great battle to start this inning. What a great job by the leadoff hitter. He knows that this pitcher's starting to get up there in pitches. The manager's starting to get restless. Let's see if we can knock him out and get into that bullpen.
Laureano is under this one, and he's got it for the first out. Ready for another shot now, Giancarlo Stanton. He went down on strikes last time up.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
Took a little off, and it's in for a called strike one. Out in front here is this one scorched foul to the left. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. And another foul ball. And he connects with it. This one's hit deep out to left center field. Laureano is back to the track as he takes it for out number two. Now settling in now, Aaron Hicks. He's one for two in the ballgame. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. Taken but called a strike. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Again, he sends it out of play. The 0-2 once more. Two out, nobody on. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Piscotty's there for it, and that ends the inning. So the Yanks go 1-2-3, but they're on top 2-0. Chris Davis next to bat to start things out in their half of the sixth as they look to shake things up here for a lineup that, quite frankly, has been non-existent today.
No doubt about that, Matt. They've been completely overmatched to this point. One hit through five innings. I mean, what else can you say about the pitching they faced other than it's been fantastic? We'll see if that continues as we approach the later inning.
Started to go around there, but he holds up ball one.
They say the toughest pitch in baseball is a located fastball. I disagree. That nasty slider is tough to hold up on.
And that fastball is too much for him there. 1-2.
This pitcher's bringing it with some high velo. You better get that front foot down early and get ready, or he's going to throw it right by you.
And he lays off the curveball. Strike three called, and that's going to be out number one. Pretty clear he didn't like the call there on the outside part of the plate, but probably too good to take, and he's down on strikes for the second time.
Yeah, that pitch was right on the black. Beautiful pitch. And even if we had robot umps, he'd still be out. But the only difference would be he wouldn't be able to complain about it.
So that'll bring up Stephen Piscotty as he takes a cold strike at the knees. It's 0-1. Hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat. Fouled off. Grounded to short. Torres brings it in. On to first, and there were two downs. And out of the plate, Austin Allen. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. Fastball just misses, that's ball one.
Hey, a two-out walk right here would be the tying run to the plate. Even though it's early on, you got a guy on deck that has a lot of pop.
That misses 2-0.
Well, we all know he's not the greatest threat with the bat up there. His numbers certainly aren't that pretty. But, hey, I give him credit. He's really working the count right here.
They haven't played perfectly as it's hit on the ground. Torres has it. Throw in time, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the A's. They're still down. It's 2-0. Mike Fiers is is on the pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Number 50.
Next for New York, Miguel Andujar. Already the beginning of the seventh inning here is... This game has had a very brisk pace to it so far. Here comes the first pitch. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. Sent out to straightaway center field. Center fielder giving chase. He's there and records the first out.
Now batting.
Now at the plate, Gary Sanchez. He comes in 0 for 2 thus far. First offering on its way. Fouled away. Bases are empty, one man out. One and two to the Yankees catcher.
Love the high heater right there to raise the hitter's sights. Let's see if he buries something in the dirt right here.
Count still at one and two. Now here's the pitch. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at two and two. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. The 2-2 one more time. Hit high and deep out to left. Davis going back, still going back. And just like the ex-girlfriend who ain't coming back, that one is gone. It's a solo shot here for Gary Sanchez. Second home run early in the year as the Yankees move out to a 3-0 lead.
Hey, that's the price you pay right there when you try and sneak a fastball past this guy. Power hitter, and every power hitter in the league knows you got to start with the numero uno, number one, man. You got to get on the heater and adjust to everything else, and he did just that.
So now to the plate, Gio Urshela. This will chase one up around the letters here for strike one. Fires. Stands 6-2 and throws from the right side. He was taken in the 22nd round back in the 2009 MLB draft.
I know this guy wouldn't go into the category of superstar, but to grind out the career he has being drafted where he was, my hat's off to him.
The windup and the 0-2 pitch. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Davis is under it. Two down. Here's Brett Gardner now. A hit and two tries for him so far. First pitch on its way. Right side, but it's well foul. Bases are empty here with two men out. Tries to shave the corner with that pitch, but it's one and one. Oh, good action on the two-seamer there, and it's one and two. Low with the fastball that time. Two balls and two strikes. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Piscotty on his horse. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Yanks able to add on one more via the solo home run. Get up and stretch. Home half of the seventh coming up. It's now 3-0 New York. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And digging in is the outfielder, Ramon Laureano.
Starting to run out of time. They haven't been able to score any runs as we're moving late into this one. A perfect time for this leadoff guy to try to get on base and ignite a rally.
Just able to get a piece of that for strike one. The windup and the 0-1. Now a rocket deep down the line in left.
One that's hit high and deep, you hope that it goes foul and it hits off that foul pole. It makes that doink noise. You want to cry. As a hitter, you want to smile because you were able to keep one just fair.
Into the box now, Tony Kemp.
Second baseman.
As he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball 1-0. He's 0-2 in the ballgame so far. Pitch to the plate is a slider for a strike, and it's all knotted up at 1-1.
Well, he's done a real nice job with that breaking ball in this start. That's not the first time he's locked a guy up with it.
Line shot to first, and there's one away. So striding in, Marcus Semien. He's 0-2 thus far in this one. Here's the first pitch to him. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Swing and a miss, and he's in control, 0-2.
That was a good swing right there. Might be the best one he's had all night because he was right on it.
A shortstop behind with a 1-2 count.
Hey, this is a real pesky hitter right here. As a pitcher, you really like to keep this guy off the bases. This is a guy that kind of sets the tables for big innings.
A swing and a shot hit down the corner. Definitely had the distance, but it winds up a foul ball. And he struck him out. Strikeout number 8 now in the ballgame for him.
This inning didn't get started the way he'd hoped with that home run, but I've got to give him credit for flushing it and coming back here to get strikeouts on the last two guys. He's acting like it didn't even happen before.
And that'll bring up Matt Olson. As Tanaka jumps ahead of him here at strike one.
This guy's throwing a gem so far. Biggest key, 80% of his first pitches have been for strikes.
Off the plate and in, it's a ball and a strike. Two out, nobody on. Grounded to the right. LeMahieu's got it. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. The A's strike for one on the solo homer. We'll march on to the eighth. It's the Yankees 3 and the A's 1. Ready to begin the eighth, and set to go is the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. First pitch coming, here it is.
Looked like he was going to wait him out, see if he was going to come over the heart of the plate. Well, newsflash, he is, and this hitter is going to adjust his batting gloves, and he better be ready in the box.
Popped him up. Semien is there for it. He's got it one away. Ready once again, Aaron Judge. He was a double play victim last time around.
He doesn't have to worry about that in this situation, Matty. No one on base right now. Try and get something up so you can drive the baseball.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And a ball 1-0. And this is going to find the crowd down the left field line. It's a ball and a strike. The 1-1. This is line to left.
Davis
is in his tracks now as he makes the catch for out number two.
Well, he hit that ball pretty well, but the only problem was that he pulled off it just a bit. The location was a little on the outer half, so he would have hit it even better if he would have stayed through the middle of the field with it.
Now batting, Torres. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. First pitch of the at-bat. Check swing, but he held up in time. Ball one.
Great job to be able to lay off that pitch right there. You could tell the minute it came out of his hand, his eyes lit up at the plate.
And he fouls this one off. The 1-1. And it's fouled away. It looked like the fastball got away from him there. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
And this one misses inside, a ball he walked him, and they've got themselves a two-out base runner.
Now batting.
Yusmeiro Petit takes over here with the runner at first and two gone in the inning. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Giancarlo Stanton. In previous matchups with Yusmeiro Petit, he's really struggled 0 for 10. He's ready. Here's the first offering.
Well, late in a game like this, calls that don't go your way can really throw you off when you're on the mound, but you just can't let it happen. His composure is getting a little test right here.
Now the 1-0. Hit high in the air. There it goes. See ya! A long two-run homer off the bat of Giancarlo Stanton. Sixth home run on the season for him as they stretch the lead to 5-1.
Yeah, and that home run is an absolute backbreaker. You still have some baseball left to play here, but with a 4-run lead, it could be a non-save situation. So they might get the rest of their closer the rest of the day. 4 runs feels awfully good.
Now batting, the center fielder, Aaron Hicks.
To the plate now, Aaron Hicks. As he lines it hard to the right side, but out of play. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. And this one just misses off the corner. Looks like a right-hander's gotten up to throw now in the Oakland pen. Bases are empty here with two men out. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1.
Looks like this guy's afraid to throw the ball in the strike zone. Gave up that home run earlier in the inning. Needs to get back to being aggressive.
Two balls and two strikes to Hicks now.
Hey, boys, you talking about getting your ace swing off right here? That's what it looks like. A guy with massive power letting it eat.
Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. The 2-2 one more time. Swung on, and this one's driven in the air as well to deep right field. And just like the ex-girlfriend who ain't coming back, that one is gone. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. Home run number 5 on the year, and it's now a 6-1 ball game.
Another excellent swing right there. That's multiple home runs in the same inning. Watch yourself. You're missing over the heart of the plate.
Now batting, the first baseman, Miguel Andujar.
In now, Miguel Andujar. As he'll take a look at a strike on the outside corner, it's 0-1. With this one almost in the books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Well, Matty V, I don't know what your thoughts are, D-Roll, but boy, when the weather starts to warm up and the ball starts jumping out like this, it's clear that the pitchers need to start making better pitches.
Yeah, just great approach. No one really chased today. Really stayed staunch on their ability to get that pitcher to come into the heart of the plate, and they did damage with it.
Now batting.
As a hitter, the only feeling better than hitting a bomb is driving one into the gap like that. He hustled out of the box knowing he was guaranteed a double, but I think he had thoughts of maybe a triple if the outfielder hadn't gotten it back in right now.
Yeah, there really wasn't any question about that one going for extra bases off the bat. J.B. Wendelken enters the ballgame out of the pen looking for the final out here in the top of inning number 8. Yeah, you might have drank a little brain alcohol. Standing in now, Gary Sanchez, fouled off. He's got a hit in 3 at-bats to this point. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1.
Hey, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, that's right where you want to miss. Any lower, and he'll probably make you pay for it.
Checks his swing here, but he does so in time. 3 runs already home here. Fouled away. Here now the 2-2. Started to go. Did he hold up in time? Yes, says the first base umpire. It's ball 3 now. Hit high in the air. There it goes. See ya! A 2-run home run off the bat of Gary Sanchez. His second home run of the game, as this is now a 7-run ball game.
Up next for the Yankees, the third baseman, Gio.
At the plate, Gio Urshela. As he will take strike 1 on the fastball here, no balls and a strike. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. Here comes the 0-1. Checked his swing there. Did he go around? No, says the first base umpire. Ball 1. Here's the 1-2.
2 balls, 2 strikes.
2 out, nobody on. Line down the left field line. But no one gets to this one as it lands in the home bullpen, a foul ball. Ready with another 2-2. Brett Gardner would be next. Now the payoff pitch home is a swing and a miss. That's strike 3. So they really tee off here for 5 runs in the inning, thanks in large part to 3 big flies. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the 8th coming up. The Yankees are out in front, 8-1. Striding forward now is the DH, Mark Canna. He'll be the one to lead off against Masahiro Tanaka.
It doesn't look very promising so far in this one as we move into the later innings. Down by a bundle, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Well out in front of the breaking ball there for a strike.
There's another pitch for a strike, and this guy's really attacking hitters well tonight, being aggressive early on. And if he continues to throw strikes like he is, he's going to have a pretty good night.
Count is 1-2 now. Here it comes. And he rings up another one. Make it 9 strikeouts for him in the game.
Yeah. He's just ringing up strikeouts left and right. Yeah, and what's really impressive to me, he hasn't walked anyone either. He's just pounding the zone. Yeah. His students are dirty today.
With the goal links. Got me reminiscing about my old day. 3-6-7.
Yeah. No. And that'll bring in Matt Chapman. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. He's hitless in his 2 at-bats so far. A ball and a strike to count to Matt Chapman. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2.
Yeah, Matty, he's had these guys on the proverbial rocking horse all night, changing speeds, hitting every quadrant. He's tough to hit.
2-2. One out, nobody on. And he struck him out. The 10th victim sat down on strikes thus far. Striding in, Chris Davis. It was a backwards K, a strikeout looking for him in his last at bat.
Yeah, in today's game, certainly don't get completely reprimanded for too many strikeouts, but no one likes to go down looking. Expect him to be a little bit more aggressive at the dish this AB.
Hit hard down the left field line, but it drops foul down there in the home bullpen area. Sinker misses, and it's 1-2 now. Bases are empty here with 2 men out. And yet another strikeout here. His 11th of the ball game, and this one ends the inning. A's are gone in order. It's still an 8-1 ball game. All set to start the 9th in this one. And up next, the left-handed hitting Brett Gardner.
Brett Gardner.
From the stretch. Here we go with inning number 9 as the first pitch misses for ball one. He's ready. Here's the 1-0. And he makes good contact there, but this is going to find the stands foul down the right field line. And he's a little too high with that one. 2 balls and a strike. Three and one now to Brett Gardner. And he fouls this one off. Now the 3-2 pitch. Pulled toward right center field. And this is taken in just shy of the warning track for out number 1.
Now that.
So the lineup flips over and digging in, DJ LeMahieu. He flew out in his last at bat. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Bases are empty, one man out. That's by him for strike one. Now the 1-1 pitch is a fastball that misses. Two and two. Now here's the pitch. And it's fouled away. One out, nobody on. Lifts it into the air to shallow center. Here's the center fielder, and he tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out.
The right fielder.
Digging in once again, Aaron Judge. No hits in three tries so far. He's struck out once. First offering on its way. Down the left field line and deep. And this will wind up a foul ball. That misses wide. One ball and one strike. Two out, nobody on. Two and one. Fouled off. Here now the 2-2.
Thank you.
If you're at the plate right now, you have to realize who's on deck. I guarantee you something's over the heart of the plate. You have to be aggressive in the zone right here.
And there's strike three. So we'll see now if they can manage to hold on to this huge lead as the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. And it remains an 8-1 ball game. Jonathan Holder, a 6'2" right-hander, jogs in to take over on the mound.
Number 56, Jonathan.
Ready now, Stephen Piscotty, starting things for his side in the ninth as they face the improbable odds of trying to come back in this one.
Yeah, not a lot of hope for them at this point. These guys know these bats still count, at least for their own stats. You can't mill in your chances as a professional.
One ball, no strikes to count. The 1-0.
Two ball, no strike.
Well, he was definitely looking fastball here, and he got one, but that was good discipline to lay off and get himself into a 3-0 count.
There's a good breaking ball as it gets the bottom of the zone.
Now, that's a really curious pitch selection. 3-0 and turn to the slider? You have to wonder if maybe he's lost the feel for his fastball.
Three balls and two strikes for Stephen Piscotty.
When you get yourself to a 3-1 count and you get a fastball, those are the ones you really want to punish. Couldn't get the bat on it, so we'll see if that comes back to haunt him.
Fouled away. Swing and a miss, and that'll get a groan from the home supporters here. One away. Final line there for the Yankees starting pitcher. He was on point from the get-go this evening.
Yeah, he looked really dialed in from start to finish. This is the kind of outing you hope for every time you go out there. So I think he'll feel pretty good about the effort he put forth in this one.
At the plate now, Austin Allen. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. Grounded softly down the line toward first. on to first, and now the A's are down to their final out. So the batting order turns over now and set to go. Ramon Laureano is working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Here comes the first pitch. Turned on down the line, and that finds its way through for a base hit. The relay, not in time, and he's in there with a double.
They haven't had much luck so far tonight, so they'll definitely take that extra base hit. It only takes one, so maybe they can string together a few and get back into this thing.
Into the box, Tony Kemp. As he pops the first pitch foul behind the plate, he's hitless in 3 at-bats to this point. And this is swung on and missed, so now they find themselves down to their final strike tonight. Last strike now for Oakland. And he gets strike 3 called to end it here, and with that, this one is over.
Yeah, that's what you want to do when you're playing on the road. Take it right to the home squad and get a win. Now the pressure's off. If they get one of the next two, the series is theirs.
8-1 is the final tonight. The New York Yankees a nice fifth inning to take the lead, and they never gave it back. Masahiro Tanaka earned the win, his second, allowing only a pair of hits in 8 full innings pitched. Paul Blackburn takes the loss despite allowing only 1 earned and 1 unearned run. So that's a wrap here tonight. Martin Rosa, Dan Pinzak, and Heidi Watney. This is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
Final line score tonight. First for the victorious Yankees, 8 runs on 8 hits. No errors. They left 4 men on base. For the Athletics, 1 run on 3 hits. 1 error. They left 2 men on base.
Inside the Show. Here's your host, Justin Allegri.
Welcome, everyone. A very happy Easter to you from all of us here at Inside the Show. Let's recap how Saturday's games played out. Looking first at the American League East, the New York Yankees held their opponent to just 2 hits as they defeated the A's in Oakland 4-2. The Toronto Blue Jays got 11 hits overall as they grabbed the win against the visiting Royals 7-5. The Cleveland Indians beat the visiting Rays 7-1.
Inside the Show with Justin Allegri.
The beginning of the work week, and welcome to Inside the Show. Starting in the AL East, the Yankees brought out the rooms in a 3-game sweep as they defeated the A's in Oakland 5-4. They now have 5 straight wins. As of today, the A's are in last place in the AL West, while the Yankees sit in first place in the American League East Division. The Blue Jays totaled 13 hits as a team as they dethroned the Royals 12-1. In the standings, the Blue Jays are in fourth place in the AL East.